Hello and welcome to another of MATLAB Helper's amazing videos on stock market with MATLAB. So starting from this episode of this video, we are going to talk about how we can code the backend for the application, for the livestock data application that we are designing. So to begin with, we need to write the code to let the user search any company that he wants to search by just typing in a few characters in the company's name. Post that, we also need to display or populate the table that we have added here, the table for currency, for stock market, and also for commodities. And we also need to let the user choose one company from this list box here. And once the user has chosen the company, the user should be asked to click on this button, fetch data, and the real-time stock market value for the company will be displayed in this particular table over here. And corresponding to that, a plot will also be displayed in the axis just below that. And when the user is satisfied with the results and wants to stop seeing the live data, what you can do is you can just click on the stop button on the right side over here. So we need to add some code to actually implement all these functionalities. So just begin our discussion by going to code view and talking about the variables or the properties that we'll be needing throughout our application. So first of all, we have declared a property called Yahoo ticker symbols. Now this is a property that we'll be using to store the data that we have in the Excel spreadsheet. Now this Excel spreadsheet is actually a sheet that contains data about the stock companies that the Yahoo website displays, and it also contains the ticker symbols. Although it has some extra information apart from the ones I've just told you, we are only interested in the company's name as well as the ticker symbols for the time being. This particular variable, the ticker symbols, will contain all the data pertaining to the stock companies from the Excel spreadsheet. However, we'll only be using the data for the stock company name and as well as the stock company ticker value. After that, we have a variable called firm. Now, this particular variable will be used to store the firm that the user wants to search. So this will be just a set of characters that the user wants to look up from the spreadsheet that we have. Then we have the variable discontinue. Now, as the name suggests, this variable will be used to discontinue the loop that we will be implementing to fetch real-time data at continuous intervals. So this particular variable's value will determine whether or not to break the loop. After that, we have the variable chosen firm. This is the firm that the user will select in the list box of results that we displayed after the user has entered the firm. Thereafter, we have two variables, xdat and ddat, So these two variables will be used to plot the real-time data, where xdat will contain the real-time stock price, as well as, and ddat will contain the real-time data value. The last variable, mainapp, is something that we'll be ignoring for the time being. We'll discuss more about it in further videos. It's all about the variables that we have declared and we'll be using throughout the application. We'll obviously be using some other temporary variables throughout this particular code view, but these are the only ones that we'll be using across functions and across callbacks. Let's just move on to callbacks. Let's begin with the starter function callback over here. So this particular callback will be executed when the application starts for the first time. So we begin this particular callback function by making this cover area about which we discussed in previous videos visible, so that the components behind it become not visible to the user. This will ensure that the user does not become very impatient after not seeing any values in these tables. So this particular text area will just hide the components which are not at the time being populated by some data. Apart from this, we'll also need to display a message that tells the user that the application is running and the patience of the user is much appreciated. So this is what we'll be displaying, and we are saving the MatchBox class, this particular class, in the variable m, and we'll be closing it at the end of the starter function. So after this, what we'll do is we will make this list box, the search result list box, invisible, so that when the cover area becomes invisible again, the user just sees this search tab and just confused by this list box just beneath it, hiding the table that's behind it. So we just want to show the list box when the user has typed in some characters in the search edit field and has pressed enter. This would show the computer that the user is interested in searching the particular characters against the company names and ticker names that we have. Post that, we have some code that is used to fetch or import data from the spreadsheet. Now this particular code is MATLAB generated. What you can do is you can just select, use the import tool in MATLAB and import it as a function or as a script, and MATLAB will generate a script for you with the required coding here. So this will reduce the amount of time that is required to write the code all by yourself. Basically, this command uses the function xlsread to read the spreadsheet, and there are several sheets within that spreadsheet, and it's a really long and memory intensive spreadsheet, so we are only importing the stock sheet inside the spreadsheet. And after saving the data in raw, what we're doing is we're converting it to a cell, and suppose that we are doing some kind of cell manipulation and looking if there are any empty cells and replacing it with NaN. And NaN is just the short of what number. And thereafter, we are saving that value in a table. And this table is actually in a variable, Yahoo ticker symbols, that we have discussed about a while ago. So this is all the code to save the required data as a table in Yahoo ticker symbols variable. So first of all, we are saving the ticker value, then the name, the exchange, the category, and the country from where that stock company is listed. So these are the values that we can import from the spreadsheet, but only the first two other ones we'll be using throughout our coding. So once we have the required data from the Excel spreadsheet in the variable Yahoo ticker symbol, what we'll do is we'll just remove the variables or clear the variables that are not required or which can be cleared out in the memory so that we have some memory left out for other purposes. Okay, this is what we are doing here. We are just removing the variables which we do not need anymore. Post that, we are calling three functions which will be used to populate the tables we have in the design views, specifically the table for currency, stock market, and commodities. So these are the tables we will be filling in with values, with data, by calling these three functions. I'll just add the semicolon here. And after we have these functions have been run and the data has been displayed, what we'll do is we'll go on to making the text area covering the entire UI invisible, so that the user can now look at the data that has been fetched from the Yahoo Finance website in the tables. Although this table will remain blank, and also this axis will remain blank as well. So this is what we'll be coding in the starter function. If you wish to add some more features there, you may do so, and if you have any doubts in understanding what I have done in this particular section, of importing the data. You're all free to ask me in the comment section below. I am leaving the explanation. I'm leaving this to you so that you can employ your gray cells and try and understand how these lines are used to actually extract data from this spreadsheet. In any case, if you have any doubts, feel free to ask me in the comment section below.